Hello everybody, my name is Petr Koutný and I have for you today a really interesting game Kasparov-Kramnik. This game is interesting because Garry Kasparov has lots of chances how to win this game, but at the end he will be checkmated by Vladimir Kramnik. So just imagine Kasparov's face and you will see upset, nervous, unhappy and he doesn't mind. We are looking forward to see a really interesting game between two top world chess players, and I hope you will enjoy this video. So let's come back, and we are watching Slav defense. Slav defense is a really interesting chess opening where both sides are playing for a win. Main idea for white is to play in the center because white has advantage, more space in the center. Black is active on the right side of the chessboard and he's playing on a wing, but as you know, if somebody is playing in the wings, the best answer is to play in the center. So now we will see what's more important, it's a center play or wings play. But anyway, this theory is a really deep, well-known theory, and in this position, white has two options. White should go for short castle or for move e4 immediately. I will show you sideline of move e4 and then we will watch game Kasparov-Kramnik where Kasparov played short castle. Okay, if black know what to play, he has to play after move e4 immediately move c5. But now move c5 is not okay because black will lose on b5 pawn, so he has to play b4. He will attack knight on c3 and now move c5. He is attacking twice on e4 and white has to save this pawn. So white is playing nearly often e5 and now short castle. This position is getting really messy because everybody know that we have to go for short castle immediately. We have to play with all our pieces, and if we are black, we doesn't have a right to lose a time. And now black is okay if he will take on d4 because he's attacking a center. You know, if white will lose a center advantage, he will lose all advantages. So white has to be careful and he has to play rook to e1. He is going to defend this pawn and one day he will take d4 pawn. Now g6, bishop to g5, and this position is really interesting. It's open and both sides has chances to play for win, but as I told you, this is only sideline and we are going to watch game Kasparov-Kramnik because this game will be really exciting. Short castle a6 because the main plan for black is to play c5. Now watch bishop on b7. This is bad bishop because c6 pawn is like wall and we need to have that open window. So c5 and now d5. Black's king is in the center, so it's a dangerous position for black because white has nearly all pieces in the game and he's going to shoot black's king nearly soon. Now, what do you think? What's the best square in this position for this knight or this bishop? What do you think? Where you will find the best square for this pieces? Yes, of course, is the square c5. But now on c5 is a pawn, so it makes sense to play c4. We should attack d3 bishop and we are winning for us a really interesting square c5. That's okay, but dangerous for black is that he's staying still in the center with his king. So, you know, you have advantage to gain c5 square, but disadvantage that this position is risky for black. And, you know, white is Garry Kasparov, one of the biggest attackers of all times. And bishop knight to d4, knight to c5, black is attacking on e4 twice, b4 he took and b4. So now black is attacking this knight And if this knight will move somewhere, black should win a4 pawn for nothing. And what do you think? It's a good idea to take this pawn or no? Important is this piece. If black has moved short castle, everything's okay. But now, I don't know if you are so brave and you will take on e4 pawn. But don't worry, Vladimir saw this move and he took on e4. And he believed that this position maybe is risky for black, but if you have the right pieces in the right squares, you should go for this risk. You know, it's important to take at the one side a risk and at the other side, if you have good pieces. With good army, you should play for small risk. Okay, take, and he took on, Garry Kasparov took on e6. Of course, not good idea to take back because knight to e6 and it's hot. This position is really bad for black. So what to play? And now this game is going to be really interesting because everything is in fire and Garry Kasparov and Vladimir Kramnik are starting to play a really amazing game. So now, of course, Garry took on f7 and asked black what he will play. You have two chances to take by this piece or this piece. What's really important in this position that black has to go for a short castle. If black will stay next to three moves in the center, is maybe lost. You know, it will be brutal attack, and for this reason is good to take with a black queen. If while black will take with this piece, is check, and I know, no, I don't believe that black will survive this position. For this reason, to be brave, Vladimir took on f7 by his queen, f3, and he went to h5. So he doesn't mind to lose a knight. Of course, if white will take, we will take, and looks like white will have difficulties because we are going to take here. And now short castle, and it will be big fire, and this is not a really nice position for white to play. Now he played move g3. Maybe the best time or best answer is to take on g3 immediately. Vladimir Kramnik went for short castle. I believe that this move is a safe move, and it's making sense to go for short castle. Maybe if he will take on g3, and now short castle, looks this position really interesting because these two bishops are really great pieces attacking the right squares, and you know, maybe even black is piece down has good compensation like that. And it's interesting position. It's interesting position, hard for play for everybody, but Vladimir went for short castle. As I told you, in this position is really important to go for short castle, but this knight is lost. So from now, Garry has one piece more and maybe is winning. Is winning because this attack is not winning attack. Yes, of course, is going to h3. And now Garry is playing bad move, knight to f3. I will show why Garry Kasparov was upset, because the winning move is to go to e2. Why? Because, for example, after this move, he will take, and now is check on f1, and you can see check, and black has to exchange the most important piece. Without queens, there is no attack, and white should have more material. So that's something what white missed, and he played bad move. What we should learn from this mistake, that if we are under attack, and I will show this variation one more time, is good idea to search for exchanging. With less attackers, we have more chances to survive. So something like that is a good time to go for endgame. And somewhere here, white is winning. Okay, but he made a mistake, and I hope we learned from this mistake, and he went knight to f3. And you know, Vladimir Kramnik is brave chess player, and he took on g3. Wow, this is move what I'm looking for if I'm watching beautiful chess games. One more time, Garry Kasparov is missing winning move, and of course he has to go for endgame like this or like this, but he has to exchange black's attackers. If he will not exchange black's pieces, maybe this position will be risky for him, and he played knight to c5. He believed that he will attack b7 bishop, but this b7 bishop is not important for black. Yes. What do you think now Vladimir Kramnik will play in this position? I will give you 5 seconds, and because this position is messy, you should do your best to find the best move for black. And black took on f3. Of course, we are taking, and it's 2 variation here, maybe the last chance for white to save this game. If white will take this piece, it will be a really bad position for him. Last chance was to go for defense, and you know, lots of players are strong in attack but weak in defense. I am not speaking that Garry Kasparov is weak in defense, but you know, you can see that everybody is making mistake if they are under pressure. So the best move is to go to a2, and I will show this variation till end. Looks like a small edge for black because black has bishop against knight, but I believe that black has advantage, but if white is Garry Kasparov, has good chances to save this game. You know, every times we have chances. It's up to us if we know and how to use our chances. So he took on f3, but now watch this firework. Check on h2, and what do you think now? What you will play if you are a black? So now it's not difficult position and not difficult move to find. So it's your time. What black will play in this position? And yes, if you are able to see this threat, well done. You are playing like a big attacker. So yes, this is good threat. 2 bishops, open position, that's what this bishop loves. Okay, check. And now what to play? Is another good lesson for us. If we are playing chess, doesn't matter if we are attacking or defending, we have to play with all our pieces, and that's really the most important plan in our chess. So we have to play with this rook, and of course we are going to e8. What's the threat? Threat is to take on e4 and then checkmate on a1. For example, if white will play two big moves, I will show the threats. So he will take here and is checkmate. So that's the threat behind move rook to e8. And now finally white went to a2. It's too late. Winning moves here is to take on d3, and I will show beautiful checkmate. And maybe it's up to you if you are able to see this variation when black will take on d3 till end, till checkmate. So maybe stop this video for another time and ask yourself if you are able to watch 4 moves. Okay, check, 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 and checkmate. So that was another amazing variation, and I hope that this game is really amazing and it's worth to see this game. But Vladimir he knows that he's winning, and you know he's playing against Gary Kasparov, check on h1, and check on e4, check on g2, and he took on a2. So now everything's changed, but still widest problems because he has so many weaknesses. So he took this piece, check, check, and somewhere here, Gary Kasparov resigned. He's lost because he's losing piece and he's going for lost endgame, of course. So what we saw really interesting Slav defense. And one more time, somewhere here, it was a risky position for Black, but he believed that with good pieces, he will survive. So, a risky position, and now he doesn't mind to lose knight. Of course, not every time our attack is without mistakes, but it's up to our opponent to find the best defense, and Gary Kasparov missed his chances twice, and he lost after beautiful move, bishop to g3. And one more beautiful move, rook to f3. So, Black is rook down and still is playing for win, because activity is the most important rule of chess game. You have to have good pieces, active pieces, and then you don't mind that you has less material. So that's everything. We are at the end of this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you saw a really interesting chess game where Gary Kasparov was upset. And at the end, we have new experience how to play chess, how to improve our chess, and how to love chess. So thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you very much for every likes and follow. And I hope I will see you soon in our YouTube chess channel in the next coming new video. So that's everything for now. Thank you and see you soon. Bye bye.